We can stand here all day reminding ourselves just how much we hate each other, but you don't have the time.
Commander, it's been brought to my attention that the sole Cardassian living on your station has been assaulted.
I'm surprised how quickly the news reached you, Dukat.
Then why would this boy attack poor Garak? An amiable fellow, if ever there was one.
If you like, I'll try to find out.
He called Commander Sisko right after this happened. Apparently, he was quite concerned with your well-being. You never mentioned you were friends.
Do you think they simply slipped from our minds? And who, would you guess, was in charge of the Cardassian withdrawal from Bajor?
Who's been tutoring you in Cardassian social studies, Doctor?
Your old friend, Garak.
Well then, perhaps you should remind my old friend, Garak. They made the decision to leave the orphans behind.
Why would Garak want to undermine Gul Dukat?
I'm not really sure. I don't think he likes Gul Dukat very much.
I'd like to ask Garak about this myself.
Dukat takes an interest in this orphan boy who recently arrives on our station. And then soon afterwards, with Gul Dukat's assistance, we discover that the orphan boy isn't really an orphan boy. He would never have left a file to be found.
Do you really think he purged the file on Rugal?
I would have.
There was something in that file he didn't want anybody to see.
Exactly.
I don't remember her name, but she was attached to the command post at Terok Nor. Is there anything else, Doctor?
For the record, the commanding officer of Terok Nor 8 years ago was Gul Dukat.
Why did you want to expose Dukat? What's the truth about you and him?
Truth, Doctor, is in the eye of the beholder. I never tell the truth because I don't believe there is such a thing.
Have you tried using your code to shut down the security program?
Oh, several times, but for some reason I can't begin to fathom. Gul Dukat chose not to trust me with his top-level security codes during the occupation.
Garak! Graveling in a corner. That alone makes my trip worthwhile.
Only targeting non-Cardassians.
If you had been on the station when I designed this program, I would have made an exception in your case.
Well, you've always been short-sighted.
Maybe you two could settle this at another time!
You're right, Major. But believe me, Garak, that time is coming.
Even your own computer program turns against you.
I always knew your short-sightedness would be your downfall.
I don't see you coming up with any ideas. Taylor?
There's much better taste than to be attracted to you. You, a married man.
I should have executed you years ago.
Oh, you tried. Remember?
Garak, this isn't helping.
Do you remember a gull named Dukat?
Dukat? Oh, yes, the business with the arms merchant. Mm-hmm. I take it you'd like to have him eliminated.
A thought had crossed my mind.
Cardassia has enough problems right now.
You're having trouble keeping the civilians in line?
I suppose there won't be much demand for your services anymore. Looks like you'll be hemming women's dresses for the rest of your life.
That's close enough, Garak.
I wanted to make sure that the council members were safe.
Why don't you go back to your little tailor shop and sew something?
Because if the Klingons do invade this station, you may just need my help.
Just remember, when you fire that thing, you're aiming it at a Klingon.
I'll try to keep that in mind.
I find this hand-to-hand combat really quite distasteful!
I suppose you prefer the simplicity of an interrogation chamber!
You have to admit, it's much more civilized!
He turned his back to me, and I must admit that for a moment, he made a very tempting target.
You'd shoot a man in the back.
Well, it's the safest way, isn't it?
Gul Dukat will take all the credit.
Poor Garak. Dukat's a hero, and Garak's still stuck in his tailor shop hemming trousers.
Perhaps I should say hello after the game.
That's Gul Dukat's daughter, and I can't think of anyone in the galaxy who hates you more than he does. Besides, Zial is a friend of Kira's, and I wouldn't play around with her if I were you.
I'd had visions of Zial presenting my head to her father as a birthday gift.
That's a little paranoid, wouldn't you say?
Paranoid is what they call people who imagine threats against their life. I have threats against my life.
Kira and my father both told me that you used to be an agent of the Obsidian Order. That you had my grandfather tortured and killed, and that you could easily kill me without a second thought.
So, what shall we talk about first?
My father would be furious to hear me say this, but there's something about Garak I find fascinating.
Yes, he has his moments.
Your hands off her!
Father, no!
You touch my daughter again, I'll kill you.
You know, I think that actually helped my back. You do have a lovely daughter. She must take after her mother.
You've done nothing to stop it?
She was lonely. The last time I checked, he's the only other Cardassian living on the station.
The man is a heartless, cold-blooded killer.
Like I said, he's a Cardassian.
You're leaving now.
I can't go.
It's him, isn't it? That despicable tailor you don't want to leave because you're waiting for him? Is a promise to an enemy of your family more important than obeying your father? So be it.
The last time I checked, I was a Cardassian.
But not a very popular one, I'm afraid. At least not with the head of the new Cardassian government.
And who would that be?
Gul Dukat.
Zial made her choice. As far as I'm concerned, she is no longer my daughter.
You know, Dukat, I thought you'd changed in the last 5 years. I see I was wrong.
But then I thought, well, no, I can't fight all these Klingons by myself. So I let him live.
And now you regret it.
Ah, my dear Constable. Before this day is over, everyone on this station is going to regret it.